Welcome to part four of my series on the work of the Queen Sawapa Memorial Institute. Today's video features venom extraction from white-lipped pit vipers. Look at those fangs. The venom of this species is hemotoxic, meaning that it attacks red blood cells. I myself have been bitten on the foot by a white-lipped pit viper. At first I thought I'd been bitten by a giant centipede, which I am really quite scared of, so it was actually quite a relief when I shone my torch down and saw that it was one of these vipers. I did go to hospital, but didn't require antivenom. The only symptom that I suffered was a swollen leg from the foot to the groin for about 3 days, and then just below the knee for a further 2 days. However, once again, this was just my personal experience, and I have heard of people suffering much more severe symptoms. Part of the work of the Queen Sawapa Memorial Institute is education, and we can see these children are really fascinated by this wonderful live demonstration. Perhaps she will grow up to be a great herpetologist. As you can see, these snakes are quite lively and are not the easiest to control with hooks. So the staff here are having to employ pincers and other tools to safely handle them. Research suggests that the antivenom produced from this species is effective in treating bites from other members of the genus. Currently, 17 species of Trimerosaurus are recognized in Thailand, and it seems likely that that number will grow in the future. Indeed, this species, the white-lipped pit viper, shows variation throughout its range, which suggests that it may be a complex of species that might be split once more genetic analysis has been done. This is a relatively short species of snake. Males typically reach about 60 centimeters in length, with adult females growing to around 80 centimeters. It is found throughout much of Thailand, with the exception of the northern provinces. It is one of the species that is quite often encountered by humans, as it will live in parks and gardens, and can even be found in central Bangkok. Therefore, encounters are quite frequent and bites are relatively common, but fatalities are rare. The only instance that I'm personally aware of was of a cancer patient who was being moved for treatment in a hospital and was bitten by a viper that was on the wheelchair that was being used. Quite extraordinary. He is fascinated by this, isn't he? In addition to the monovalent antivenom used for Trimerosaurus species, the snake farm also produces a polyvalent antivenom that can also be used to treat bites from Malayan pit vipers and Russell's vipers.